Good morning, kids at home. It's good to be able to share with you all again as we're celebrating a special day today, Mother's Day. We thought it would be fun to have a special guest join us from Kids YouTube to share a very important message from the Bible. So say hello to Douglas.
My mom is awesome. Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas, and today I wanted to talk to you about Mother's Day. Yeah, and how we can honor our mothers, how we can honor our moms. Now for me and my family on Mother's Day, we like to show my mom how much we love her because she does so much for us. She really does. She does so much for my family. And so on Mother's Day, we let her sleep in and we give her breakfast in bed and we write cards for her and we get her little gifts and we try to do all these nice things to show her how special she is to us. And you know, it's interesting because in the Bible, you probably know this, but in the Ten Commandments, it says that we should honor our father and mother. And that's the first commandment with a promise. It says that if we do that, if we honor our fathers and mothers, then things will go well for us. But usually when people are talking about the Ten Commandments and they get to the honor your father and mother part, they say, you know, obey your parents. And if you honor your mother, then you're going to be obeying her, so that makes sense. But you can totally obey somebody without honoring them. And that's not what God wants. God wants us to honor our father and mother. You know, my neighbor's cat is the worst. I usually think of myself as a dog person, but I've known several cats that I really liked, but not my neighbor's cat. He is so gross. He always knocks over our trash cans and gets in the garbage and eats it. And he always makes a huge mess. It's disgusting. And if we hear a trash can get knocked over, we always open the window and say, "Hey, get out of here, cat." And he'll always obey us, but he always does it real sassy, right? You know, he doesn't talk, but if he could talk, he would totally be like, "Yeah, fine, whatever. I'll get out of here. I didn't want your garbage anyways." Yeah, so he like obeys us, but he doesn't really care about us at all. If he honored us, if he cared about us, then he would, you know, not knock over our trash cans. Or if he did, he'd at least apologize. And so honoring your mom is a lot more than just obeying her. When you honor your father and mother, you are valuing them highly. You're being grateful for them. You are respecting them. You care about what they say and how they feel. And so the stuff we do for my mom on Mother's Day is totally an example of honoring our mothers. But we should be doing that all the time. Now, maybe we can't do all the things that we do for my mom on Mother's Day. Maybe we can't do those things every day. But when I sit down to write the Mother's Day card for my mom, I always feel really grateful for her because she's done so much for me. And I get this really happy feeling inside because I really love my mom. You know, on Mother's Day, we pull out all the stops. We do all the nice things for my mom. And so maybe we couldn't do Mother's Day every single day. But every day we can show my mom that we love her. Every day I can show my mom that I respect her and honor her. It's not just about obedience, it's about love and respect. And so that's my challenge to you guys today, is that you would honor your mothers. Not just on Mother's Day, but every day. Because if you do, things will go really well for you. It's the first command with a promise. Our moms are amazing. So let's look for ways this week that we can show them love and respect and honor. Hey guys, happy Mother's Day! And you know, on Mother's Day, it can be kind of a hard day for some people, right? Because not all of us have moms that are there for us. Not all of us even know who our moms are. But I think that on Mother's Day, we can show honor not just to, you know, our moms, but also to the women in our life who have been there for us. And we should be thankful for the women that God has put in our life that have helped us along the way, that have been there for us. You know, maybe you've got a teacher or your grandma or your aunt or a neighbor. I want you to think this week not just of ways that you can show your mom honor and respect, but how can you honor the godly women that Jesus has put into your life?
Hopefully Douglas has helped us all understand a little better the importance of our attitudes we have while doing what God asks of us in regards to honoring our parents. And I get it isn't always easy, but we can ask Jesus to help us do what is right. He can change our hearts to do things happily and with a willing spirit. Let's pray now. Heavenly Father, I ask that you would help us all, and especially the kids, to do what their mums and dads are asking of them, happily and willingly, just as the songs and Douglas have talked to us about. And I pray that you would help them, that they would know your joy and your peace as they do what is right from your Bible. I just ask your blessing on them all now, and pray that you would protect them and guide them during this time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Some kids think their parents make too many rules. Clean your room, make your bed, pick up your dirty socks. But God says when you obey and respect your parents as the leaders of your home, then life will be better for you.
Deuteronomy 5 verse 16. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord your God has commanded you, that your days may be long, and that it may be well with you.
Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord your God has commanded you. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord has commanded you. That your days may be long, that it may be well with you, with you. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord has commanded you. Days may be long, that it may be well with you, with you. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord has commanded you.
Obedience is the very best way to show that you believe. Doing exactly what the Lord commands, doing it happily. Action is the key, do it immediately. Joy you will receive. Obedience is the very best way to show that you believe.
O-B-E-D-I-E-N-C-E.
Obedience is the very best way to show that you believe. We want to live pure, we want to live clean, we want to do our best. Sweetly submitting to authority, leaving to God the rest. Walking in the light, keeping our attitude right, on the narrow way. For if we believe the word we receive, we always will obey.
O B E D I E N C E.
Obedience is the very best way to show that you believe.
Okay, that's it from us. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
God bless. Bye.
Bye.